If you want to draw images with AI, plenty of AI generators available online can help you do so quickly and easily. So why do we burden our computers with a large program that can strain your graphics card and drive up your electricity bill? From a personal perspective, experimenting with different tools and techniques can be a great way to learn and grow as an AI artist. Stable Diffusion and its associated add-ons and models are ideally suited for final customization. You won't find such a wide array of functions combined in any online manufacturer. By blending checkpoint and LoRa models or even conducting Boolean transactions between multiple checkpoints, you can create something truly unique, a model that is exclusively yours. You can also train the model using your existing artwork, allowing you to print in your distinctive style. Second advantage is when higher resolution is needed, you can go as far as you want if your graphics card is sufficient. In online services, including paid ones, there are restrictions in these matters. Also, there's no limit to quantity. You can generate images day and night and place bulk orders, receiving results the next day. If you possess programming knowledge, the possibilities are boundless. Despite all the praise, there are challenges. Software and packaging issues can bog down your computer, akin to an increased electricity bill. Furthermore, it can be slow. Today, I'll discuss Stable Diffusion on Krita once more. If you haven't installed it yet, there's a video guide available. You can set it up by following these instructions. It's quite straightforward. The initial setup includes two checkpoints, which are sufficient for beginners. Each file is 2 GB in size. One is oriented toward creating generally realistic images, but it has a somewhat generic structure. It can generate whatever you have in mind, but often in a simplified manner. To infuse more imagination, you'll need to work with prompts extensively because the model doesn't inherently understand our intentions, it merely draws what it's familiar with. For instance, if you desire a nature-themed image, you can create a simple mountain, forest, or waterfall. However, if you want a scene that combines both winter and summer, the results may appear odd. To address these issues, loading too much into the model can cause memory-related failures. If you visit savitaai.com, you can find models that excel in various subjects. For instance, if drawing anime characters is your focus, you can easily download and employ a model specialized in that. While such a model excels at drawing anime characters and environments, it might struggle to depict a real car convincingly. There are numerous additional models that you can add to the core ones. For instance, LoRa stands for low rank, a mathematical technique used to trim down the parameters during training. It retains essential elements instead of saving everything, resulting in faster training and image production. You'll need to copy it to the LoRa's folder. I've created beautiful and imaginative nature images using this model, in conjunction with these LoRa models. I've blended them at a 25% ratio each. You can adjust this depending on the emphasis you wish to place on the base model. In the first image displayed on the screen, the LoRa weight is set at 25%, while the second is calculated at 75%. Both of these images were generated using the same seed. I consistently choose a fixed seed to ensure the same image is produced every time. Ordinarily, the seed value is generated randomly with each attempt. Since the seed varies, predicting exactly what the models will include or exclude is challenging, making each image almost entirely unique. It's feasible to create similar results with settings other than the seed. Allow me to provide a brief explanation of these settings. I had previously published an installation video. If you haven't installed it yet, you can watch that. Quickly, download the Stable Diffusion plugin for Krita from GitHub. Unzip the compressed file into the pykrita folder. For Windows, it's in the AppData folder. For Debian, Ubuntu, and Mint Linux, it can be found under .local in the home directory. I will add these paths to the descriptions. Replace the username here with your own. From the menu, go to Settings, Configure Krita, and click on Python Plugin Manager. Open a new file. In Settings, Dockers, select the AI Image Generation checkbox. Press Configure in this new Docker that appears. Press the Install button. If everything goes well, it will download around 10 gigabytes and work. I opened Krita and ran the server. In the combo box at the top, I can see various style files. I have many styles in my collection. Through experimentation, I create a new style for achieving good results, although many of them may not work. These files are kept in this location, and it's sometimes beneficial to create backups. To create a new style, I click on the plus button and provide a name. Then, I select the model file. If there's a missing file, I refresh the directory with the refresh button. From here, I choose a LoRa file and adjust its weight. Multiple LoRa files can be added. Here, I add positive words. I copy and paste previously prepared words. Some LoRa files may require trigger words, which can be general words like nature or specific keywords. It's essential to check the page where we downloaded LoRa, otherwise, LoRa won't work. In the next line, I'll write negative words, the ones I don't want. I leave the version selection on automatic since the checkpoint version selected here is already visible. I keep sampler selected, and as I increase sampler steps, the image's quality improves, but the production time increases. This choice is up to me. The number of steps used for upscaling the images is determined here. If I'm working with high resolution and need a more precise image, I increase it slightly. Guidance strength indicates how faithfully the prompt will be followed. Higher values provide closer results. If you want a surprise, keep it low. It doesn't have much impact on performance. Selection Grow and Selection Feather help determine how much the selection extends beyond the image when making corrections, additions, or deletions. If you're not satisfied with the results, you can adjust them here. If you want the same image to be generated each time, select the fixed seed and enter a number. This is a useful tool to see the effects of the changes made in other settings. To get the image I want, I initially try it in low resolution and directly enter it here. Sometimes, finding the right prompt can take time. If the results are not good, I use ChatGPT to help me with the prompt until I capture a good image. Of course, the model checkpoint should be suitable for the desired outcome. The same prompt can produce very different results with different models. Thank you for watching the video. I would appreciate it if you could subscribe.